Good evening, everyone. I'll just wait for 3 more minutes for people to join, and then at 4:05 we'll start the session. Thank you. Okay, guys. Good evening, everyone. So hope you're all doing great. So I'm assuming you all have tried to install Photoshop on your systems or laptops. Okay. So we'll have a quick recall on what we have discussed yesterday. So we have covered introduction and basics of Photoshop. So within introduction, we have talked about importance of image and design. So where exactly we use them. And what can we do with Photoshop, like what all can be done with Photoshop, the history of it. And in basics, we have learned how to open Photoshop, the interface drawer. So what all we can do with the interface. So how to open a new, absolutely new document on Photoshop. And the 3 main tools. So we have learned just the basics of it. One is Mark Move, and one is Mark You, and another one is Lasso. So in today's session, we'll try to learn in detail about layers, blending tools, and the selection tools in detail. So which are Move, Mark You, Lasso, Quick Select, and Magic Wand. Here we go. So we'll cover these topics today. We'll try to learn in depth about these tools. Okay. Coming to layers. So layers are one of the important features of Adobe Photoshop. It is working with layers. Let's assume our Photoshop is our dinner plate. So then layers are like rice and curry in that particular plate. So it is so important. You have to understand the importance of layers. So there are like many important features in Photoshop, but none of them play such an important role compared to these layers. So these layers are like foundation of Photoshop. So Photoshop actually stands on the layers is what I can say. So layers help you to stack or rearrange any object, effect, or what you call like adjustments of the image, whatever you want to. So layers not only help you to create some complex graphics, but it also allows you to play with the image without making any commitments to its overall composition. You can edit the image with the layers, but the original image lies there and then and there itself. So you don't have to move the original image. Without moving that, you can actually play with the layers. So you can select a particular part of the image. You can put it in another layer. You can edit it. And then you can create some complex designs out of it without disturbing the original image. So that's how, layers work. So these all make layers more fundamental part of the design process. So to start with, let us use some documents and then, try to work with the layers. Let's do some practical sessions. Okay. Now we'll import a picture to the Photoshop. So let's open the Photoshop. So here we go. I would like to import some pictures out here. So I'll go to my Google. So I'll just say Unsplash. If you remember, this is the website we have discussed yesterday. This is a free image downloading site where you can download some free high resolution images, which are like royalty free and copyright free. For an example, now I would like to download a picture, let's say nature. See, I have some beautiful images downloaded. So I actually like this picture. So all that I'll have to do is click on this picture. Picture got opened. I'll go here. I'll say download free. I can close this window out here. My image has been downloaded. I'll click on this arrow. I'll say show in folder. I'll say control X. I'm removing this file from the downloads tab. And then I'll go to my Photoshop folder. I'll paste it. So my image has been downloaded. So I'll rename this image. I'll right click on the image and then say rename. And then say, I'll say teach. Okay. Now I would want to download another image. I'll say building. I have three pictures of building out here. I'll download one. So I'll just say again, download free. Close this window. I'll copy paste the same here in my folder and then I'll say building one. So this is done. So I have downloaded my copyright free images from this particular site. Now back to Photoshop. So this is how an interface looks like in the first go. I can either go to file and then say open, or I can directly say control O. Control O is a shortcut, keyboard shortcut for opening a new file. Now, I want to work on three files simultaneously. So I want to upload three files. How do I do that? Make sure your file types is all formats. Now, I want to select three photos out here. So I can do this. I can drag three photos, whichever I want to, and then select them. Or I can say control, and then I can select on the images that I want to work on. So here you can find that, you know, these particular images have been selected, and then say I can say open, or I can say control A. All the pictures have been selected, but I don't want this folder or, you know, this particular thing to be down uploaded. So I'll press on control and then I deselect them. So these particular things have been deselected for now. I just want to go ahead and then upload nature and the building. So I've pressed on the control key. I've selected two pictures. The two pictures have been selected. I say open. Two independent files, or I can say two individual files, have been opened with individual layers each. They have set to the background. Okay, so I have opened all three images. So each file has one layer which has been locked. Okay, Photoshop by default, whenever you upload a file, so it by default considers this particular file as a background image and it locks it up. You can release the lock, that shouldn't be a problem. I'll tell you how. Now, I would like to combine these two separate pictures into one. How do I do that? Okay, so I want to create multiple layers in a single image. So I don't want to work on two files, but then I want this particular file to be here as a layer. So how do I do that? So I can either say, I can click on move tool. I can select this picture. I can drag this. And then I can go to this particular first file. See, my cursor has this plus symbol, right? So just because I have folded it, so it has the plus symbol. Whenever I release the mouse, the plus symbol is gone and my picture has been loaded on the top of the background image, first image. So this is, the layer has been created. But see, I don't have this picture in the right center, right? So I'll say control Z. So my picture has been gone. What I'll do is again, move this file, click on move tab. I'll just click here, drag go to the first tab, and then I'll press on shift key. I'll press on shift key and then I'll release the mouse. So now it has come to the center. So whenever you want your image to be there in the center, you will just have to press on shift key. Okay. Now my move tool will drag and drop by pressing the shift key. So now I can go ahead and I can actually delete this file because I don't have any problem with this file. There is another option wherein you can move this file to this particular file. You can just say select all, so the entire picture has been selected. You can come to this layer and then say edit. Sorry, you just have to go to this picture. You have selected all and you will have to say cut. So the image is gone here. You will have to come here and then say paste. So the image has been come here. So there are two images. So I can delete one layer out here. So I'll just say right click. I can say delete layer, or I can drag this layer to the trash bin out here. So the layer has been deleted. Okay, so now I have my two layers out here. Now, I can unlock this particular background to normal layer by double clicking on the name. When I double click on the locked image or a background image, a small pop-up comes out wherein it will ask me to rename the layer. I'll say building. Then I'll say okay. See, now my lock has been released. Now instead of, you know, being a background image, it has come to a normal layer. So this is my layer building, and even this layer I can actually rename it here itself. I'll say bird. Okay, my two layers now have been selected. Now, so why is like my first layer locked? This happens because this is the first layer that was uploaded, and by default, as discussed, Photoshop locks this layer. So now we have converted the locked background layer to a normal layer. So if you want to move the layer, so if you want to put up building on top of this bird, you just have to select the white space between the layer. And then you will just have to click and then drag. So here we go. So first you have the bird layer, on top of it you have this building layer. So here you can drag and drop things. It's again to default. So now what if I want to see through the layers? What if I want to make this bird layer transparent to this particular building layer? How do I do that? I have an option here called opacity. Okay, we can actually see through the layer by decreasing the opacity. So opacity, the lesser the opacity, the more transparent you can feel. See, I'm decreasing this percentage and now you are able to see the background building image very neatly, right? The higher the opacity, the second layer actually closes off. So transparency is the opposite to opacity. The more transparent, the less you can see. So you can, you know, work with this opacity. Now, we'll discuss about the blending modes. So whenever I'm decreasing the opacity, I'm able to see through the image. But what if I want to give some effects to this particular image? So I can do this with this particular option out here. Now, by default, these are the options of opacity itself. So by default, it is into normal. So let me, you know, put up something. For an example, put up multiply. See, you have a different shade altogether. Or probably I'll say overlay. See, so you can actually play with these options. So whenever people are combining like two images, so this is the best option to blend. So you can directly cut the layer, put up on the layer one, and then you can blend it up. You have like many options here. So if you have time, please go through these options, explore them. Layers and blending tools are really, really interesting. Probably, you know, you can do the immense combinations of pictures whenever you're free. They're really, really interesting, guys, trust me. If possible, just cut the image and then probably place it on layers and then try to blend the tools. Now we will know how to cut the images. Now, we have different tools in Photoshop, right? To start with, we'll pick up the selection tools. So these are the first section. So you find a line out here, right? These all are the selection tools. So now, in today's session, we will learn the move tool, marquee tool, lasso tool, and the quick selection tool, along with a part of crop tool. Okay, great. So now, all the images that are displayed in computer monitor are of pixels. So every image has like thousands of pixels, right? Now, think selection as highlighting group of pixels. For an example, okay, let us do this. Let us do the practicals parallelly so that we can understand. For now, for my reference, I am just deleting, or probably I can hide this particular layer. So I have this construction building image, right? Now, when I'm selecting something, that means if suppose I'm selecting this particular tower, that means I'm selecting a group of pixels in this particular image, right? So the advantage is that you can edit them without affecting the rest of the image. You can just select these pixels, you can move it out, and then without this, I'm so sorry, guys. There's a technical issue. Okay, now, for an example, if I want to edit this particular tower, I can select this, move to a particular layer, and I can just edit this particular image and then come back and then paste it out after editing. So I don't have to edit the entire picture. So the entire picture doesn't come into my view and my view doesn't get deviated. So this is the main advantage of it. So previously, we have seen how to select the entire image by selecting the all button. So the entire selection has been made. So I have then cut and then pasted it to the another layer, right? For this image, we have done that. We have selected the entire image, and then we have gone to edit, we have set cut, and then we have come here, and then we have pasted the bird image to an entirely new document. Now, the selection tool helps us get more specific with our selections. No, instead of putting the whole image, we can, or a whole layer, we can actually select some shades or pads or individual colors or whatnot. We can actually do anything possible. So probably we'll get started. Yeah, we'll start with the marquee tool. We'll say rectangular marquee tool. Okay, see, my cursor actually changes. The way it operates, the marquee tool, is like very simple and straight. You can click and draw a rectangular part wherever you need. Okay, you can also drag it. So I have drawn this particular thing. I can actually drag it to another place, but the image doesn't come out. Okay, I can drag it to any place, but the image doesn't come out. So what if I want to drag the image also? Then I'll have to go to move tool, and then I'll have to just a second. I'll just delete this layer. This is causing the problem. Yep. See, now I'm able to move this tool. Just because I've just hit the layer is still there, but it was hidden, so I was not able to move it. So I've deleted the layer out here. Now I'm able to move the section. Now, done. So whenever you want to restore something, you can just say Ctrl-Alt-Z. It's like undoing your particular task. Now, So whenever you want to do a, whenever you want to cut a, you know, a square shape or a rectangle shape, you can use this MarkU tool. So now whenever you want to do it in an elliptical shape, you can just right click here, the second tool in your left toolbar, right click and then select elliptical MarkU. Suppose if you want to select a particular face or something or an object which is in an elliptical shape or a circle shape, you can use this tool. Okay, this is like similar to the rectangular one. So if it doesn't give you a perfect shape, you don't have to worry about it. All that you will have to do is click on shift. When you click on shift and then when you draw, you will get a perfect circular shape. If you don't want an elliptical shape, so you can click on shift. Just a second, guys. Okay. So whenever you want to start a selection with in the middle of the screen, so you can click on Alt Shift. So Shift is for getting a perfect circular shape and Alt will help you create a circle in the middle. So now just see. So all in all direction it expands. So not only in one direction, it expands in the circular direction. For that, you will have to click on Control and Shift. These Control and Shift options work the same way for the rectangular MarkU tool as well. Okay, whenever you want a particular, you know, perfect square shape, you can click on Shift. And whenever you want to expand in all directions equally, you can click on Shift and Alt tabs. They work in a similar fashion. Now, what are the single row MarkU tool? So whenever I want to select a single row, or whenever I, for an example, I just want to select the buildings part. I don't want the sky part. So what I'll do is click here. So this particular tool, it gives a single horizontal line, which the height of this is 1 pixel, just 1 pixel. And you can, you know, cut wherever you want to. Now, so single column MarkU, it's the same thing, but it's in a vertical shape. So the width would be 1 pixel out here. So if you want to have this section to be cropped, or if you want to work on this section, if you want to make any selections, you can, you know, work on this. You can cut and then you can put it in another document or put it in another layer and you can work on it. So generally we don't use these two options. It is only rectangular MarkU and elliptical MarkU that we use. Now, the next is the lasso tool. So yesterday, in yesterday's session, we have seen like how to cut an image, right? So this first lasso tool, which is the regular lasso tool, it will help you to cut a particular section in a specific shape that you want to. So let's see it right now. So I can draw it and I can select it. I can move it in any shape that I want to. Okay, so I have just selected this particular tower and then I have just, you know, it's a freehand tool basically. You can select whichever section you want to with this particular tool, but you will have to make sure you close the loop properly. For an example, I'm selecting this and I'm selecting this. And I have left it over out here. So what it does is it calculates the stop point where I have, you know, released the mouse, and it calculates the start point where I have started, and then it draws a straight line. So only this particular section gets selected. For that, you have to make sure you close the loop properly. So wherever you are starting, just remember, and you will have to close the loop. So whenever you are near to close the loop, yeah, this particular section I've been selected. What if you forget to close the loop? Don't worry, we also have an option for it. So you have this shift key. So for an example, you have selected this particular tower and you have closed the loop. And now you feel that you also want this particular tower to be selected. So you will have to click on shift key. Shift key and then start working on it. So this shift key, by pressing on shift key, it will help you to expand your selection. So it is now connected with it. Okay, when you don't press the shift key, and whenever you start the selection, this particular selection will be gone, and only this particular selection will be there. But when you press the shift key, both the selections will be selected. Suppose if you don't want this selection. So for an example, you have selected this particular selection by mistake and you want to delete the selection. So how do you do that? You click on Alt. You click on Alt and then select this particular thing. See, this particular selection has been removed. You can also remove this particular selection. This is removed. So only this particular tower has been selected. So basically, Shift will help you to expand the selection and Alt Tab will help you to decrease the selection. So whenever you press, just you know, observe the cursor out here. Whenever you press on Shift, a plus symbol below the balloon the cursor symbol appears. So whenever you press on Alt, the minus symbol appears below the cursor or a balloon symbol. So basically, Shift is for adding something and Alt is for deleting something. Okay. Now, so when I say Control Z, it removes everything possible that we have done. Now I'll go to Polygon Lasso tool. Okay. So it uses straight lines and points from selection. So whenever you want to select something which doesn't have curves or anything, or if it doesn't have any shape, and if the particular thing that you want to select is in a straight lines, this particular tool is the best. It actually selects straight lines. So whenever you're close to the end point of the loop, a small zero appears down the cursor. Probably you're not able to see it out here. I'll do another selection. See, whenever I'm close to the loop, a zero appears below the cursor or the polygon symbol. Are you able to notice it? It's quite visible. So here it doesn't appear. Now when I'm moving to my you know, start point, so a zero appears, which indicates that my end loop has come. So I click on it. So this particular selection has been made. Now, what if I want to select everything except this particular building? What can I do? So I'll just say select all. So everything has been selected. So now I can again select this and then remove this particular thing. I can also inverse the selection. For an example, I have selected this particular tower. This particular tower has been selected. Now I want to select everything except this particular building. Then I'll go to select and then I'll say inverse. So everything except this particular building has been selected. What if I want to deselect? I'll say Control D, or I can go to select and then say, I'll go to select and then say deselect, or I can do a Control D. You have this control command out here. Control D will help you to deselect everything. Now comes the magnetic lasso tool. So this magnetic lasso tool is such an interesting thing. So it's basically called the smart lasso tool. Okay, we can roughly select the area that we want to select, and this tool automatically adjusts the selection as we drag. It fills up the blanks as we go. I'll tell you how. You have selected this. So just suppose I want to select this particular building. So whenever I move this mouse, I am not even clicking. So whenever I move the mouse, it automatically selects. So it basically helps me to work, it actually, you know, understands like the work section that I want to work on, and then selects everything possible wherever my mouse is like moving. So when you want to deselect, you can again say Control D. Whenever you say Control D, the entire thing will be like deselected. So we generally don't use like magnetic lasso tool. We go with normal regular lasso for some elliptical or some curvy images. We go with like polygon lasso tool if we have like straight images. That's it. So generally, whenever we are designing something, it is very important to, you know, see each and every pixel of it, understand each and every detail. Hence, we don't go with this, you know, vague selection. So we go in detail selection. Hence, we use the first two lasso tool options. Now, so our next selection tools will be like, you know, very, very cool. So they are designed to make the selection process much faster, like magnetic lasso tool, but they are like very specific when compared to magnetic lasso. So this is called as quick selection tool. So this automatically selects the areas that are far away from our cursor. We can press hold on Alt if you want to subtract anything or probably shift to add anything. For an example, see my cursor is like not just to a point. It has got a circle around it. Okay, the circle has rounded the cursor. So I can, if I want to select something, I can do that. So if I want to select this complete thing, I'll just have to say, see, I just want to select this and my particular selection has been made. This is a very smart tool, so I can drag it out. I can drop it out. If I say shift, my selection will be expanded. If I say alt, see, when I say alt, my cursor, just observe the cursor. When I say shift, it is like remaining plus. When I say alt, it changes to minus symbol. So I don't want the selection to happen. I'm saying minus and the selection has come down. Okay, this is how it works. You can actually adjust the cursor out here. You can select the cursor. You can decrease it or increase it to your wish. So as I increase it, my cursor length increases, or as I decrease it, my cursor length decreases. You can also do this with the bracket symbol in your the keypad. So whenever I'm pressing on the bracket symbol on my keypad, the cursor length gets increases. So whenever I'm pressing on another bracket symbol, the cursor length is decreasing. I'm sure you're noticing this. So the open bracket is for decreasing the length and the close bracket is for increasing the length of the cursor. Yeah. Now, I'm deselecting everything. I'm just pressing on Control Alt Z to go back to my original page. Now, so this is how the quick selection tool works. Now we'll go to magic wand tool. So what is this magic wand tool? This is like, basically used to isolate the backgrounds of the images. So for an example, I do not want the background image of this particular image. I do not want all these clouds. What I'll do is like, I'll click here. Everything got selected. So I don't want this background color, and the rest colors have also been selected. But why? So what happens is it picks up color we initially selected, and then it selects the number of similar colors close to it. For an example, I have selected this blue color, right? So it picks up all wherever there is this particular blue color, and then it selects the entire portion. How does it select? So how many colors does it pick? You can see it here. The tolerance is 32. So it means it selects 32 shades of the color that I have initially selected. So whatever color that I have initially selected, it picks up the 32 color variants that are close to the particular color that I have selected the first. So here the tolerance level is 32. If I want to, I can actually increase the tolerance level or I can decrease it. Now, just because I have an option out here on the top menu, contiguous. If this is unchecked, it selects everything. It selects it selects the color wherever it is there on the image. For an example, if I've clicked on pink color, it selects the pink color wherever it is there on the image, and then it crops it off. For an example, if this is check, now I've selected on blue color, so it only picks up the blue color wherever it is there on the background. It doesn't touch the image portion of it. So only the background, color will be picked up with the tolerance of 32. It means it only selects the 32 variants of the color that I've initially picked up, but it doesn't touch the image of it. Only background has been selected. If this particular thing is like unchecked, then if this blue color is present somewhere in these buildings, even that particular thing will be checked. So this is the advantage of this particular tool. Okay. Now, we will go to the crop tool. We'll quickly understand the first crop tool, and tomorrow we'll work on slice and select tool. I'll quickly say Ctrl-Alt-Z to remove all the work that I have done. And now I've selected the crop tool. So crop tool is basically the manipulation tool. So previously, whatever we have discussed, select a particular area in an image or isolate the background and all. So that is different. And now we will understand how to manipulate the image without affecting the particular image, without affecting the rest of the image. Now we know how to select the layer's content. We will now know the tools to manipulate the content. Great. So the first tool, as I've discussed, is the crop tool, right below the magic wand tool. So whenever you click on it, all the content gets highlighted. So I'm just highlighting the content out here. So whenever you move the cursor, the double arrow appears out here. See. So whenever I'm moving the cursor, my double arrow appears. I can either remove this, crop this off, or I can get back to the original shape. Whenever I click on enter, whenever I'm just trying to crop it off, chop it off for that matter, whenever I click on enter, it means I just want to work only on this particular thing. Again, I'll say Ctrl-Alt-Z. I'm back to my original image. I'm again selecting the entire section. I again have all the options to move my picture. Now, here, I can, with these particular, double arrows, I can move my image. I can actually change the angles of my image. Okay. So what if I want to move the image in a particular angle? How do I do that? So I can press the shift key, which allows me to move the image in particular angles. I have again cropped it off. I'm able to move the image. You can use this move button. So whenever I'm pointing out on the image, I'm able to move it as well. So I have these options to crop it off the angle that I want to. I can actually play with the images. Most of the designers play with this crop tool. they add a background out here. So we initially have this plain black background, right? So they can actually play with this background. So for now, I'm just, you know, using this. So this is how I can actually play with this crop tool. So probably in tomorrow's session, we will cover how to use slice and slice select tool. If you have any doubts on this session, you can actually shoot it out. We'll close the session with this particular slice tool, crop tool, sorry. So I'll just have a quick rewind of what we have done today. So we have understood how to, you know, what are the importance of layers in Photoshop. So how to open like multiple files parallelly or separately in Photoshop, and how do we move particular files to one particular file and then create individual layers, and then how to edit the layers. Then we have seen the options to blend the layers and different options for that particular blend tool. And then we have started working on selection tools. We have seen how to select the particular image, how pixels can be selected. We have worked on lasso tool. We have worked on marquee tool. We have worked on polygon marquee. We have worked on elliptical marquee, single row and single columns. We have then come to lasso. We have seen how to work on regular lasso and then polygon lasso along with magnetic lasso. And then we have just started the selection tools. How to select a particular thing. And then we have come to the crop tools, which are manipulation tools. And then we have just started with the cropping tool. If you have any doubts, you can shoot it out. We'll wrap the session for now. And then probably tomorrow, we'll continue with the rest of the items. If you have any particular doubts, you can shoot it out, or you can probably send a text message. Okay, thank you all. Thanks for your time.